Hello everyone, welcome to the 90 days Bible study and welcome to Arewasdiary. This morning we are going to look at Psalm 110 very quickly. I'm going to read out the scripture to us and we're going to look, take a deeper look at what the scripture says, and also an heads up, I will not be posting the video on the live video today on Instagram, but I will leave a clip and then a link for the full video, which will be on my YouTube page, because I will need to edit certain things about the video before I drop it. Okay, just heads up. Alright, Psalm 110 says, "The Lord said to my Lord, sit you at my right hand until I make your enemies your footstool. The Lord shall send the rod of your strength out of Zion. Rule you in the midst of your enemies. Your people shall be willing in the day of your power, in the beauty of holiness. From the womb of the morning, you have the dew of your youth. The Lord has sworn and will not repent. You are a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. The Lord at your right hand shall strike through the kings in the day of his wrath. He shall judge among the heathen. He shall fill the places with the dead bodies. He shall wound the heads of many countries. He shall drink of the brook in the way. Therefore shall he lift up the head." Amen. Psalm 110. So this is a psalm of victory. This is a psalm of victory, and this is a message to someone out there that feels like everything has been against you. This is a psalm of assurance to someone out there who feels like, I don't know what is happening next. I don't know what next step to take, and I don't know where else to go to, or I don't know what next to expect or what next to look up to. Today, the Bible says, "The Lord said to my Lord," the Lord is saying to you right now, "Sit you at my right hand until I make your enemies your footstool." The Lord said to my Lord, sit you at my right hand. Until I make your enemies your footstool. And the Lord shall send the rod of your strength out of Zion. Rule you in the midst of your enemies. In the midst of your enemies, where you feel like there is so much oppression and there is so much going on around you, the Bible says that the Lord is saying to you that he would give you rest on every side. You should sit. You should be still, and the Lord will make your enemies your footstool. You should be still. And the Bible makes us to understand in the book of Revelation that he overcame by the blood of the Lamb and by the words of our testimony. Who have we overcome? Our arch enemy. And so today we know that the words in this scripture have been fulfilled, really, because of what the scripture says in the book of Revelation. We know that the scriptures have been fulfilled. So we can move around boldly. We can walk in the presence of God boldly. We can live on this earth boldly as ambassadors of God, knowing fully well that victory is hard in every situation. But the Bible says that we are more than conquerors through Christ that strengthens us. So we have the strength of God in us to take up the challenges of life, to overcome the situation, to weather the storms. Amen. So today, it says, the Lord has sworn and will not repent. You are a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. The Lord has sworn and he shall not repent. When God gives his word, it is sure. God has decided to take up the battle for you. God has decided to take up the challenge and to make your own problem, your own issue, your own struggle. He has decided to take over so that you do not go in your own strength, but in the power that is available in the name of Jesus, so that you do not have to struggle through life ever. So today I bring you the words of encouragement. I bring you the words of life, the words of assurance from the scripture. As the Lord has said, today we should look at Psalm 110, and that is exactly what we are doing. And I'm telling you today that of a certainty, the grace of God is available for us to have rest. So whatever that situation may be that is making you fearful, whatever that thing is that is making, that has made you afraid, that you are so afraid and so full of fear, I bring you the message of hope and peace. God is saying, just relax. I got this. You know, I got this. And I would make your enemies your footstool. I got this. Amen. The Lord is saying, relax. Relax. And it says, the Lord at your right hand shall strike true kings in the day of his wrath. He shall judge among the heathen. He shall fill the places with the dead bodies. He shall wound the heads over many countries. He shall drink of the brook in the way. Therefore, he shall lift up the head. You will be comforted. No matter what it takes, your comfort is here. You will be comforted. And peace will be restored. Your head, you will lift up that your head again. Your head shall be lifted up by the strength of the Most High. Not by your own strength, not by your sword, but by the strength of God. So no matter what the situation is that you're going through today, receive hope that your head shall be lifted up, because it is what the scripture has said. And God himself will fight your battles. So stop thinking about vengeance. Stop thinking about, how am I going to do this? How am I going to... No, just let go. Just praise the name of God. Let go. Just let go of your fears. Let go of the troubles. Let go of whatever is holding you back. Because the King of Glory, the one who rules in the affairs of men, the one who sits in the highest in the heavenlies, has decided to tell you that you should relax. Sit at my right hand. Just relax. And the Bible says in verse 2 of Psalm 110, the Lord shall send the rod of your strength out of Zion, rule you in the midst of your enemies. He has given you victory. You would rule. That is what you're supposed to do. Rule in the, even in the midst of troubles and your enemies, in the midst of perils. Rule. And how do you rule? How do you show that you're in charge? Take the example of Paul, who was taken prisoner on a journey, and suddenly was one telling them, this is what God has said. Move closer to your God. Stand in a place of devotion. Stand in a place of communication with God. Pray and be at peace. Be rest assured. Be at peace with yourself. And know that surely God is on your case. Praise the Lord. Just be rest assured that God is on your case. He's got you. And he would come true for you. He would come true for you. I don't know who you are. I don't know what exactly you're going through, but I know that God has got you. So just relax. Be at peace. Don't think about vengeance. Do good. Remain good. Regardless, be at peace. And in your peace, in that peace of mind that you have chosen, you will triumph. And your head will surely be lifted up. Amen. Thank you so much for joining today's Bible study. Thank you for being part of this journey. Today is day 37 of the 90 days Bible study. I am so excited that God has brought us this far, and I believe and I trust God that He will take us farther. Thank you so much. God bless you. Amen. All right, so please share these videos with your loved ones. And if you have not yet subscribed to the channel, please subscribe to our social media channels, our YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram. And the God of all peace, the God of all flesh, will continue to strengthen us and guide us in the way to go. Amen. All right, bye-bye. Take care of yourselves.